We're going to start our unit on recursion, and recursion just means that a method is going to call itself. So here we have an example. Here's the main method. So here's the main method, and we have a recursion class. It's called recursion 3. This is the object, and it's a new recursion 3. And then test is going to call the method run, and it's going to send 1 to the method. Well, here's the class. Here's the recursion 3 class, and it gets sent the value 1. So system.out.println 1 is printed. So here we have 1. Then if x is less than 5, and it is, it's 1, this is the base case. This is going to stop the recursion. If x is less than 1, it's going to call itself. It's going to call the run method, but it's going to add 1 to x. So now 2 is put into x, and it prints 2. So 2 is printed. If x is less than 5, it's still less than 5. It's going to add 1 to x, call itself, and so 3 is going to be sent to the parameter. And 3 is going to be printed. X is still less than 5. This gets 4 because now it's going to call itself again. Prints out 4. If x is less than 5, yep, still less than 5 is 4. So it'll send 5 to itself. Prints out 5. But now x is equal to 5. It's not less than 5 anymore. This is the base case. This is going to stop the recursion. And then it actually is not going to call itself again. So it prints out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here we have the exact same thing. We're going to send 1. But what happens when we print after the call instead of before? Well, 1 is going to be sent. And if x is less than 1, then it calls itself. So we have what's called a stack where x is equal to 1. Then it calls itself again. Nothing's being printed out yet. And now x is 2. If x is less than 5, run x plus 1. So it'll send 3. So x is equal to 3. And these are stacking on top of each other. Then x is still less than 5, it's 3. 3 plus 1 is sent 4. Notice it hasn't printed out anything yet. Nothing has been printed. So it gets a value of 4. If x is less than 5, yes, it's 4. It'll be sent 5. So x is equal to 5. So here we are. We got 5 right there. Next line, if x is less than 5, no, it's equal to 5. So it will not do this now. And it'll print out. It'll do this print statement. It'll finish this method, and it prints 5. That one's now done. Well, then it prints the next one. It finishes that method that was called, prints 4, done. Prints this one. Whoops, I don't want to cross that out. Control Z. Prints that out, done. Prints 2 out, done. And finally, finishes the very first method that was called, prints 1, and then everything is done. Same exact thing, sending 1. So we send 1, run, it goes to 2, run, it goes, x goes to 3, run, x goes to 4. This program will never stop. So you'll have a stack overflow. Eventually, there's so many that the computer just can't keep track of them, and it's probably thousands, if not, I don't know, millions. But it'll happen very quickly, and you get a stack overflow. That means we never had a base case to stop the recursion. If we look at a do while, and this is old news, this is the do while class, and it has a run method, int x equals 0, and we can keep printing out values. We add 1, so it does 1. Keep adding until we meet the condition, which as soon as x is equal to 10, we'll stop printing. So here's your do while loop. So recursion acts just like a do while loop, except recursion has it's a lot stronger. We'll write a program during this unit where we'll see how it's a lot stronger than just a loop. All right, we have recursion 1 test, new recursion, system out print line. We're sending the value 5. And so we're sending fun, the value 5. So y is 5. Let's make a note of that. Y is equal to 5. If y is less than or equal to 1, nope, it's 5, return 1. Else return, so it's going to return to this call. Well, we're going to have something and then plus 5. So this is going to get a return value, and we're going to add 5 on the first call of the method fun. But it's calling fun again. It's calling a y minus 2. Well, y was 5. 5 minus 2, now this the parameter has sent the value 3. If y is less than or equal to 1, nope, still greater than. We're not going to return 1. Else, return. So the new method that was called, y got a value of 3. And then we're going to get a return value back to this because it's calling fun. Fun is a return method. And now we're going to add 3 to whatever is returned. Well, now the new call, y is going to be 1. So now the new call, y is equal to 1. If y is less than or equal to 1, aha, it is equal to 1. So it's going to return a value to 1. So now what's returned is 1. 3 plus 1, it's going to finish this call. It's going to finish this method. 3 plus 1 is 4. It returns 4 here. And then it finishes out the 4 plus 9. And 9 is actually returned when all of this is over. Recursion test, recursion 1. Now we're sending two values. We're sending fun 4 and 3. So it's receiving the value 4, receiving the value 3. Let's make a note of that. X is equal to 4. Y is equal to 3. If y is less than 1, nope. Else return fun. All right, so now we have a return plus the x, which is 4. Now what we're sending x to x. So we're sending 4 to 4, or 4 to x, and y is getting the value of 1. So this gets 4 again. This gets a value of 1. If y is less than 1, return x, no. Else we're going to return fun xy minus 2 plus x. So this is going to get a returned value, and then plus 4. Well, now we're sending 4 to x again. So on the new call, x is 4. But now y is negative 1, because 1 minus 2, negative 1. If y is less than 1, yes, that's true. Now it's going to return x. So 4 is returned. So 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 gets put here. 8 plus 4 is 12. And in the end, this returns a value of 12. We have the class recursion 1, the object test, new recursion 1. We're sending fun 4, 4. So x is 4, y is 4. If x is equal to 0, no, that's false. Return x plus, so let's make a note of this. X is 4, y is 4. And we have 4 plus, and we're going to get a returned value when we call fun, because that's a return method. Now, what's thrown into x? Well, y minus 1 is thrown into x. So x now on our new call is 3, and x is thrown into y. So x thrown into y. So y is 4, and this x is not 0. So x plus fun, 3 plus a return call, and we keep going. Y minus 1 is put into x, which is 3, and x is put into y, which is going to be 3 as well. X is not 0 yet, so now we have x plus a return call. Y minus 1 is put into x, that's 2. Y is equal to x. X gets sent into y, and that's going to be 3. X is still not 0. We're going to return x. X is 2 plus another return method, another returned value. So y minus 1 goes into x. So x now is 2, and y is equal to 2. X is still not 0. So we have 2, which is x, that's right here, plus a returned value. Well, now y minus 1 is sent into x again. So x becomes 1, and y becomes x. X parameter sent into y parameter. So 2. x is not 0, so we're not going to return x yet. Return x plus return value. Now y is equal to 2, so y minus 1 now is 1. So x is equal to 1, and y becomes x. Y is equal to 1. So we have x plus a return value. Well, finally, we get to our base case. What's going to stop? This is what's going to stop the recursion, because there's no recursive call in here. X gets y minus 1, so x becomes 0, and y is equal to 1. So now when that happens, we're going to return x. So we're going to return 0. 1 plus 0 is 1, so now that gets 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. That gets 2 plus 2 is 4. That's going to return 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. 9 plus 3 is 12. And in the end, this whole thing is going to return a value of 16.